carpet from the middle of the hall. Students at the gallery, please start to sit from the middle of the hall. Let's come out and go to the gallery. You start to sit, you that are up there, start to sit from the middle of the hall. Thank you. Thank you.
Battle.
Capitalism.
charismatic and results-oriented Vice-Chancellor, the distinguished Professor Lilian Imuetinyan Salami. Other principal officers of our university, the provost, deans and directors of the university, our most respected professors emeriti, other esteemed professors and erudite scholars here present, top government functionaries, your Royal Highnesses, especially His Royal Highness, the Obi of Ife's Mkuu, greatest UN staff and students, invited guests, members of the 46th round, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you specially to today's inaugural lecture. This is the 233rd in the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin, and it is to be delivered by an icon, one of my mentors in drama, a professor of music and theatre performance, Professor Josephine Ngozi, Mokwunyei. Tomorrow's special recognition. The topic for the lecture is music and theater, a quintessential marriage of convenience. I now respectfully invite the Registrar of the University, O.A. Oshogi, Mrs., to introduce the Vice-Chancellor and members of the Vice-Chancellor's procession, Madam Registrar.
Distinguished invitees, you are all welcome to the 233rd inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Please permit me to stand on the exit protocol already observed by the University of PRO. It is my rare privilege and honor to introduce the Vice-Chancellor's entourage, which is led by the Vice-Chancellor herself, Professor Mrs. Lilian Imuetinyan Salami. Others in the Vice-Chancellor's entourage are the Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic, Professor Michael Akin. We also have the Deputy Vice-Chancellor of Kenwa Campus, Professor Joel Abolaga. We have the boxer, Dr. Victor Imami. We have the University Librarian, Dr. Nyu Otamudiane Obasugi. On the other side of the dais, we have provost and directors. We have the provost, College of Medical Sciences, Professor Efosa of Yasu. We have the Dean School of Postgraduate Studies, Professor S.E. Okay. We have the Post Dean, Faculty of Arts, Professor Eddie Erabi. We have the Dean, Faculty of Agriculture, the Deputy, Professor E.R. Uri. We have the Dean School of Basic Medical Sciences, Professor Mrs. Akin. We have the Dean School of Dentistry, Professor M.A. Sede, who is ably represented by Dr. P.F. Eko. We have the Dean Faculty of Engineering, Professor J.A. Akobi, who is ably represented by Professor R.O. Edokia. We have the Dean, Faculty of Environmental Sciences, Professor P.S. Obedigbe. We have the Dean of Faculty of Law, Professor N.A. Inepetion, who is ably represented by Professor Erin Okoji. We have the Dean, Faculty of Life Sciences, Professor C.E. occur. Dean School of Medicine Professor Dr. D.G. Sajo. We also have the Faculty of Pharmacy Professor M. U. Umwangu. We also have the Dean Faculty of Physical Sciences Professor F. E. Usagete. We have also Director General Studies Professor D. N. Deko. We have the Director Center for Gender Studies, Professor Mrs. E.U. Edoson. We also have the Director Center for Part-Time Programs, Professor Mrs. K.A. Gilaku. We have the Director of Distance Learning Program, Professor F.E.O. Omorui. We also have the Acting Director, Institute of Child Health, Dr. D. Emmanuel. We also have the Acting Director, IDAES, Professor F.S.O. Osara, who is represented by Dr. F.O. It is now my pleasure to call on the Vice-Chancellor to introduce the lecturer of the day.
Good afternoon, distinguished invited guests, especially the three islands in your city. I want to allow us to have a little bit of diversion. You are sitting in the midst of a sandwich between the lecturer today and the weekend. And I will tell you when the national anthem was being taken. And I heard the other crocodile when my knee going hello. So that's just to tell you that today we are in for it. So you are most welcome. I welcome you all to the 233rd Inaugural in the inaugural lecture series of the University of Benin. Today's lecture is the fifth to be delivered in my tenure as the Deputy Vice-Chancellor. The 17th in the Faculty of Arts and the 3rd in the Department of Theatre Arts. This lecture is also the first by a female to be delivered by a professor from the Department of Theatre Arts. Audience, I am glad to report that the first semester activities for 2019-2020 academic session are ongoing in the various faculties, schools, and institutes. I want to use this medium to further solicit the cooperation of all stakeholders in ensuring that the current academic session runs smoothly without hitches. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and honor to introduce our lecturer for today. Our lecturer for today, she is Professor Mrs. Josephine Ngozi. The title of her lecture is Music and Theatre, a Quintessential Marriage of Convenience. Professor Mokwunyei was born on the 12th of December, 1952, from the family of Mr. Junior Osakwe and Justin Osakwe from the royal lineage of Isenupu Kingdom in Delta State, Nigeria. With traceable genealogy to the Edo Nuorisi of the Benin Kingdom, she attended Ibadan City Council in Moore Plantation, Ibadan, from 1960 and St. Paul's Primary School, Mogeli, for She enrolled at St. Mary's Mount College, Abor, in 1965 for her secondary school certificate, but finished in 1970 from African Girls Drama School, Mokwunyei, after the school was completed that education. She attended the University of Nigeria under the Benin Special Female Award and had a diploma in music education and a second class upper division in music. She had her mandatory LYC program as a lecturer at the music department of the College of Education in Benin. After a stint with Benin Television, now a new broadcasting service, she was employed as graduate assistant in the University of Benin in 1984. She had her MA in Theatre Arts from the University of Ibadan and a PhD from the Institute of African Studies, University of Ghana, in under the scholarship of Ford Foundation and International Center for African Music and Dance in Ghana. She rose through the academic ranks and fight to the position of professor in 2013. Her research focuses on music and theater performance. Professor Mokwunyei is the first female head of the Department of Theater Arts, as well as the first head of the Department of Theater Arts and Mathematics in the University of Benin. She has served at various levels and in the several capacities within and outside the University of Benin, such as one, director, Nigerian Broadcasting Corporation Music Choir from 1982 to 1984, Head of Music and Life Entertainment Department, Benin Television, now EBS, from 1982 to 1984, Member of the University Senate from 1906 and 2006 to this, as Head of Department of Theater Arts from 2017 to 18, 2018 to 19, and she has also served as chairman of the Social and Cultural Committee for 2018-2019, among others. And if we continue, we might not leave here the position we have in. Professor Mokwunyei has served as a member of accreditation panel, resource person, assessor, external examiner, moderator to several institutions, a UNICEF facilitator and a consultant of notable international and national firms and corporations. She has successfully supervised several PhDs, masters, and postgraduate diplomas, as well as many undergraduate students in the area of music, theater, and performing arts and culture. She has attended several local and international conferences where she has presented scholarly papers. Professor Mokwunyei has published over 40 journal articles, chartered books, a monograph, over 100 solo and numerous book productions and performances, and has recorded a solo album entitled Boys and Girls. Professor Mokwunyei is a member of many learned societies and professional bodies, such as Society of Nigerian Theatre Arts, Musicological Society of Nigeria, among others. Professor Mokwunyei has earned prestigious awards and recognition from various organizations and institutions due to her notable contributions to academic research and social development, such as Special Female Undergraduate Scholarship Award in 1976 to 1981, Woman of Faith Award, People's Skills and Resources Magazine for contribution to the development of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in the sphere of higher education in 2007. And also Life and Achievement Award for the Society of Nigerian Theatre Artists for 2015 and 2017, among others. Her habits include acting, golfing, singing, and cycling. She was married to Chief Dr. Anthony Uche Mokwe, the Ochudo of Isimuku of Blessed Memory, and the Union Blessed with children and grandchildren. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to invite Professor Mrs. Josephine Madam Vice-Chancellor, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Administration, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Ekemwa Campus, the Registrar, the Bursar, the Librarian, members of the University Senate, Provosts, Deans and Directors, academic and non-academic teaching staff of the University of Benin, His Royal Majesty, Obi of Iteluku, Imaloba, Damaloba, Imaloba, Ojani, Imaloba, Damaloba, a quintessential marriage of convenience. The work is dedicated first to God Almighty through His only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to Our Lady of Perpetual Health, to the memory of my late parents, Mr. and Mrs. Osakwe, to the memory of my late husband, Chief Dr. Anthony Uche Moore, and to my children, Anthony, Joy, Ethan, Edgar, my grandchildren, Isabel, Raymond, and Jalisa, you are my blessing and my pride. The drama of my employment is universe. My journey here started right on this stage when I came with a performing troupe from the University of Nigeria, Suka. I acted the star role of Bride in Bless the Bride. And as we performed, the then Vice-Chancellor Akubeki sat in the front row there. And when the curtain was drawn, yes, there was a curtain here. And I'm sure with the kind of dynamic Vice-Chancellor we have, this curtain will return here in different senses. And I was just already putting out the details of my bridal gown as the bride on stage. And the man came and said, the Vice Chancellor wants to see you. I wasn't expecting that. So, okay. And then I followed him to the Vice Chancellor. And when I got here, he said to me, did you say you are in your final year? I said, yes. He said, okay, come and see me in my office on Monday. Monday, there I was in his office, in the Ekewa campus, but this campus did not exist there. I got to the office, and of course there were people already waiting. And there was a petite lady who came out to the room where we were waiting.
know, speedily, now smiling, you know, in a different mood. Oh, okay. Pointed to a chair in her room and said, sit down, the Vice-Chancellor will see you. Once the person inside comes out, you can go in. Okay. And that was the story of my employment. The rest is history. I start my lecture this way. Musicologists, we have many of them here today. This is a little poem I wrote while I was inspired for this lecture. Musicologists are introverts, believe it or not. Thespians are extroverts. Signs and terms of music, the demi-semi quavers, not understood by thespians. Intricacies of theatre, not understood by musicologists. Yet, must collaborate to endure a marriage of convenience, to entertain, to please the audience, to deserve their pleasure. Mokwunyei 2020. My primary research interest has been the relationship between the discipline of music and music, musicologists, and then theatre, music and theatre. Musicians are the musicologists, the music I referred to earlier, the musicologists are the musicians, and then the thespians, of course, are theatre practitioners. I was well guided by the best in both areas of study. In addition to experiences gained through my work at the University of Benin, I have also been guided by my cumulative professional experience as radio and television producer, director, presenter on NTA and EBS, as well as actress, singer, on stage and on television, involved in numerous performances of Western opera, contemporary African drama, African folk songs, and other musical presentations in different parts of the world. It became clear to me while undertaking this assignment that the relationship between music and theatre was in most cases misconstrued and not even quite clear to every theatre practitioner. I was in between all the time, being qualified both in music and theatre. This opinion arose from my observation that music used in many theatre productions were in most cases randomly selected and sometimes inappropriately applied. Although music began, the study of music began from interdisciplinary perspective, studies in relation to performance have been scanty. The few available have mostly been interpreted and presented in Western terms. Some methodological approaches have been advanced by many scholars. They are named in the booklet, including some of them standing here or sitting here. One pass, and so on and so forth. This research the result of those approaches contributes significantly to knowledge by creating more awareness for original African research. When it started, our studies were done by foreigners for us, and they looked about us. But now we know better, we know it is better for original researchers to talk about their own research areas. If you're Nigerian from Iselugu, you should know much about Iselugu and write about Iselugu. Approaching music as a domain of behavioral science has contributed to the understanding of the mediated role of music as it occurs in everyday life from birth to death, more from 1999. That music follows the African from birth to death is axiomatic and a common idiom. In fact, every African is a musician, if you ask me. The average African mother is culturally involved in music in such a way that even her unborn baby begins to experience African rhythm when she dances to the tantalizing music of for music making, except in the different formats in the traditional situation. Traditionally, African children are usually encouraged to play various kinds of games to occupy their leisure time. On that night, they are treated to folk tales, accompanied with folk tale music of the local culture by the common folk. African religion. Formal study of music in Nigeria started with a Western influence curriculum, because the aim was for musicians at that time to play the organ, just know how to play the organ so that you can play it, or entertain the colonial masters and even those who took over from them. They were elite who sat and enjoyed music like you are sitting now. Classical music could be played and you will enjoy the contemplative nature of classical. You could close your eyes and still appreciate classical music. But for the African would want to listen to the music and see the music, not just listen. However, towards the 20th century, many African countries, including Ghana and Nigeria, had acquired the need for reintegration and accession gave birth to new philosophies, new ideologies, and new consciousness. In Ghana, the divine philosophy was then Sankofa, a reawakening through a reassessment of past. This is symbolized by the local Sankofa bed, that's the bed you said, which has its head looking backwards instead of forward. And the reason for this is that if you do not know where you're coming from, you may not be capable of knowing where you are going, let alone plan for your destination. You are therefore due. 1999. Correlation between music and drama. Initially, African playwrights started writing in the Western style, until they also became conscious of their identity. Are they African? To continue to enact Shakespearean plays and all of such literary plays, all go back to their roots and help themselves. Thank God now we have so many African writers and we are conscious of our identity. The awareness marked the transitional period when theatre practitioners began to depart from well-accepted artistic norms to points of differentiation and new directions. The main interest then centered on what is African theatre, its African characteristics. About four decades ago, Professor McKinsey, we would have here, served at his holiday in the U.S., thought he was unpopular to have played a drama not incorporated with music and that was right, and alien to the unalienated Nigerians of any ethnic background. On the contrary, now, 40 years after, it has become acceptable to many literary dramatists and stage critics that stage presentations, not structure and sequence with music and dance or stylized movements, I believe, are alien to the inherent sensibilities of the contemporary Nigerian theatre audience. And this is because communication in African tradition, whether it's verbal or non-verbal, because we know, yes, abroad when you want to say bye-bye, you do that. But here, what do we do? You do that. That's non-verbal communication, or you do that. Or that. So whether verbal or non-verbal, these are transmitted through three basic modes. Speech, music, or coded movement, besides all the dance. The term right refers to the dramatic style that utilizes speech as the only means of communication. I come to verities and not to praises, the king, the men, the liver, and so on and so forth. Such plays resulted in excessive dialogue without the exploitation of the other non-verbal modes that could otherwise have been useful as tools of dramatic. effect for the creation of conducive mood as a bridge between particles of melanin and entertainment to minimize the boring effect of protracted shooting. The typical African contemporary audience expects modern drama for the Nigerian state to communicate in familiar idioms, not limited to speech, but interlaced with music in one or more of its forms, such as song, drumming, instrumentation, instrumental accompaniment, background music, sound effects, and dance, as of course practiced in film. If you watch Nigerian movies, Nollywood, you see a lot of music accompanying the action. Music as enhancement too. This is where I deal with the way in which music tutors to enhance theater. My research in different areas of African musicology shows that in addition to sustaining the right mood, music stimulates and maintains the urge for expressive movement. Music also provides the basis for articulation of body movement in dance, even for dancing or as exercise. The African loves dance. That's why movement and rhythm has been introduced to the church. Because no matter how nice a song sounds, if it does not lend to expressive movement, some people don't appreciate it. We've been on this for a long time, long enough to note that you bore this audience. If I started performing, only few people will remain after the minute. But if you add some movement and some dance, of course, they are excited, they will think with you, they will dance. They like to do that. Okay, I'll give you one of the examples of a nursery rhyme. The first one is a nursery rhyme, and the second one is a children's song with nonsense syllables. Even when they are nonsense syllables, at that age, they try to introduce the children, not to all them with a lot of meaning, sentences that have complicated meanings, but words that are catchy and rhythmic. So you hear for the starting child is practicing to dance, the mother clap, put it, pa, pa, de, children, mono, pa, pa, de, wuzo, pa, pa, de. And then to when the child grows a bit, you hear the pa, pa, kolo, pa, kolo, pa, pa, kolo, pa, kolo. These are nonsense syllables that in music we call nonsense vocables. But they teach the children rhythm. Yes. The music and speech therapy. The relationship between speech and song is such that the boundaries separating one from the other could have been finally. So much is there in common, elder says, between music and speech behavior, that it is permissible to regard singing as a kind of language, having regard to the use of tone and to the semantic theological apparatus employed. Therefore, in a drama presentation, music and dialogue can flow into one another with seamless ease as in music drama. That can be achieved through singing or through surrogate instruments. When I say surrogate instruments, I'm talking about instrumentation that are very close to the human voice. Okay, you will soon see why I put this picture there. That's the lecturer and Sir Victor Waipo in the moment with some musical instruments. The speech surrogate. I thought there will be an awkward thing to escort the Obi, but Obi came with a slim entourage. It usually goes with a right one. Thank you for coming. This is a big surprise to me and I appreciate it. Thanks for your respect always. Thank you. Akwele is a typical and normal musical instrument that sounds closer to the human voice. And I explore that through its function of the tradition. The results of this study contribute to knowledge of African musical instruments by bringing to scholarly focus exhibit the aquele to show them that in other parts of the world there are similar instruments that imitate the voice. Other research papers on aquele music include other talking instruments of Africa, published in the Journal of Humanities, Legon Ghana, the endurance of the cherished instrumental tradition in southern Nigeria, published by Echo, my Journal of Theatre, and the vocalization as paradigm of Anioma musicianship, published in the International Journal of Music Education in Practice, London, by Sage Publications, Mokwunyei, 2008. Music as verbal expression. As an avenue of verbal expression, music in general and songs in particular could be used in contemporary practice either to portray the thoughts of actors or for the enrichment and continuation of dialogue. Nollywood actors have also turned into musicians. They the prospective play, or to improvise incidental music and familiar tunes on a mobile show in an acceptable traditional style of the local culture. This cumbersome methodology design managed to generate effective interest, but whether or not the real production always turned out as effective is another matter for another lecture. Suffice it to say that once successfully wooed and attracted to the venue and the play began, the aim of that publicity that started in the 80s was considered faith accomplished. Having practiced this jungle publicity as a member of faculty who has directed many computer plays for several years, I often wondered why, despite its frustration, we must resort to such financially and physically sapping strategies. I wonder if it was not more rewarding to divert such resources to the development of a style of theater that attracts the audience to watch the production for its own sake and on its own merit. That is, to watch the final creative product of musical integration and not depend on the musical packages. Musical application, however, at most points, no matter how beautiful, at the wrong time, would invariably create the wrong mood, thereby eliciting wrong reactions and wrong responses from the audience. For example, two specific examples from the Drama Week at Lagos in 1997. Yoruba music was erroneously played during a reenactment of an Igbo event, and Igbo music juxtaposed in another Yoruba scene. Upon investigation, it was gathered that the errors were based on ignorance on part of the two play directors, who assumed that any piece from Nigeria, Yoruba music, was suitable for any play from Nigeria, Igbo. It's not possible. You have to contextualize whatever kind of music that is incorporated in any production. They, however, accepted my intervention and correction and were grateful when I provided them with alternatives. That field experience emphasizes the benefits of working with a musicologist on a dance production for effective application and contextual use of music to please the audience. Because in the landscape scenario, your business is to entertain and please the audience. In a different situation in Accra, the effect of substitution from another culture or yielded a different result. And in this case, it was Fred Agbegebe's The King Was Duck Naked. This specific production was dramatically enriched with an Akan royal dubbing, with a flamboyant display of Akan music and dance, dramatized, of course, with the normal pageantry. I had watched the same play as directed by Austin Asaba. Austin Asaba, he was away in Benin here. Austin Asaba and the author Fred Agbegebe are both Shekiri. Fred Agbegebe is Shekiri. Austin Asaba is family Shekiri. So he was on familiar terrain, which was evident in his dramaturgy and contextual use of local music and dance. In 2019. At my earlier successfully directed command performance of Midnight Hotel by Premier Josephine at Government House in Benin, there was no doubt the mixed audience of visiting foreigners and the Edo State government functionaries got the message from the musical intervention. The songs were rendered by the Petronaira band as the same right call. This was conducted by my colleague, the role of songmaster played by my colleague Innocent Akioya. And those illustrations are from the Midnight Hotel. Some of the actors and actresses are here present. And you can see the mixed audience. If you look at their heads, you can get, it's not very clear. theatrical practices through which the citizens of modern contemporary theatre can be taught. A contribution to prospective directors of plays set in Delta State and Yorkshire State in scenario, I carried out such research, documented in a monograph entitled Quintessentiality, an Ancient Kingdom of the Old Empire, published online by Imuetinyan Online Publishing, Mokwunyei 2019. There's also a link, you can follow the link, and it is online. Music training for theatre arts students. Theatre arts students are also trained by music personnel, among other courses in voice and speech, music theory, music history, music appreciation, music pedagogy, organology, music performance techniques, which are examined in theory and practice, amongst other ends, in preparation for handling contemporary artistic responsibilities in the theatre scenario. With my training on both sides, I taught this music course. I also taught some theatre courses. This is one of our students who is leading the Edo cultural troupe. African-based music education for African diaspora, we cannot just selfishly pretend that we all live on the continent or in the country. So for the benefit of Africans in diaspora, I examined some traditional concepts and implications for contemporary music pedagogy suitable for African descendants in diaspora. Data presented was based on field research parts of Nigeria and Ghana. The findings show that a good background in the musical practices of an individual ethnic area enhances the full human potential of that individual. I also carried out some other studies, but for safety, but it is not included. I concluded that a viable music education program for African descendants must offer alternative experiences evolving from the perspective of African tradition, more than 2010. Creative work. In the creative arts department, academics are required to practically justify their knowledge to a specific number of productions in their areas of specialization in solo and group categories. In addition to research and publication of scholarly papers, you are told as soon as you come in that you publish or you publish yourself. So you publish as a creative artist. You must publish and you must also present the show. And my first production in Univen was the formation and presentation of the first University of Benin choir in the Benin City. This was the origin of theatre arts involvement in the University of Benin convocation and other ceremonial activities till date. The current group was later Christian Union Chorus and that when the then Vice-Chancellor, Professor Grace Alleluia, acquired some orchestral musical instruments for the group. During her tenure, I suggested and directed a Christmas carol program by our department at her official residence, and this became the first 9 lessons at carol in the universe that has now become an annual tradition. From the big waters of Salami Lilian to the Vice-Chancellor's Lodge, we moved to the main auditorium and currently holds here. Solo musical performances. I have produced over 100 major and minor music and drama shows. A few of my major productions within and outside the country include the following. The popular voice of solo long playing album recorded and released by Deko, West Africa Division. Does anybody have that illustration? Okay, that's the album theme. A folk music ensemble of the Department of Music and a team of performers, and we recorded 13 weeks program at NTA Benin, and it was used 1984 Olympics at the National Stadium, Suru Lere. You remember that? 1980. I composed a esteemed piece of music at the National Museum launch of a esteemed hair care product. It started from me, and when I finished with Benin, they had started from other states. They contacted usually local artists to compose a song for that product. And when I finished with Benin, they insisted that I must go around with them, the remaining 86 states. And I was treated like a celebrity. Thank you. Mokwunyei, 1989. I composed special Miriam when Mrs. Abacha was the first lady and came to Ghana when I was studying there. It was a command performance commissioned by the National High Commission Ghana. I had been a Deko and Yosha full-length live solo performance to mark the first annual launch of fundraising gala of the Federal Association of U.S. Youth. And that happened in Brooklyn, New York, 2000. We recorded the first CD video of nine lessons and carols. Maybe they should do it again so that everybody would have a copy, because that's an invaluable product of the University of Benin, which you can be handy for the festive season. As actor or director, I was a motor and the fugitive prince, recorded and aired as an educational program by Yorkshire Television, United Kingdom, Mokwunyei 1994. I acted the role of Amine and Imuetinyan. My husband didn't want me to act Imuetinyan, so he said, how can God act to my wife? No, you can act any other role but Imuetinyan. So they had to bend over backwards to give me the other role, Imuetinyan. But it was such a popular historical Benin video, which was one of the first, actually, in our Nollywood industry. As co-director, I just went to the end, I co-directed the NAPES 2009 Edo Stage Command Performance Entry with the ex-team director. It was such an honor to work with him. Lancelot Odua Imuetinyan, thinking by any chance. Lancelot Odua Imuetinyan is busy recording. He actually wanted me to join him on a few days ago, but I had to ask for permission not to be there. The production, that production I'm talking about, that's where the A Year Old Song came from. And the production features well-synchronized traditional music and dance that enrich the dialogue. Imuetinyan and Mokwunyei in 2009. Okay, you see that picture, can you recognize it? Okay. A marriage of convenience. The relationship between music and theater in the University of Benin for now is a quintessentially remains a marriage of convenience, each benefiting from the other. However, the 40 years of courtship of the related but independently viable program, I have had a glowing desire to see the commencement of the Senate-approved BA music program and the emergence of the music department as intended since 1985 and documented on pages 360 to 368 of the Blue Book. Madam Registrar will attest to that and probably show that page to the Vice-Chancellor, to Madam Vice-Chancellor. It is now the prerogative of Madam Vice-Chancellor to make this desire a reality, since all the human and technical requirements are now in place. A separate building is urgently required, as seen during MUT accreditation all over the country, to music departments for other federal universities, namely Ibadan, Akin and Wolowo University, University of Port Harcourt. Some of the lecturers are here present. Thank you for coming. and equipment recently delivered to the program in your tenure. The instruments delivered include a grand piano. I was dreaming of it. And when I applied, I didn't know it would come through, and I'm happy the dream come through that part. We will see and pray for the fulfillment of the rest of the dream. We have upright standard piano, we have kettle drum, French horn, trombone, saxophone, and a range of orchestral instruments. Madam Vice-Chancellor, we already know you by reputation as an astute administrator, an action woman. Hence, I am confident that this appendage to my lecture will soon become a testimonial reference history for you. We appreciate your recent visit to the University Music Program, now bursting with musical equipment in your tenure. We love your soprano voice. I wanted to play it, but there's no time. We recorded her when she came. I wasn't there, but I was recording. We love your voice, and we look forward to future performance collaborations with you, man. We look forward also to your facilitation of the still pending MUT post verification to enable us admit students to start the BA music program immediately to the glory of God. In your time. Let me take the gratitude before completion and recommendation. After God, my appreciation goes to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Mrs. Lilian, Salami. I am so happy that we have her as Vice Chancellor. The woman, yes, thank you. The woman of the moment with beauty and grace. I have this great honor and privilege to deliver my inaugural lecture. I acknowledge all three Deputy Vice Chancellors, Professor Michael and Mr. Akin, the workaholic go-getter. When you work in his committee, you have to stand up, you have to go. He wants it done now, and you have to do that. I appreciate the Deputy Vice Chancellor administration, the workaholic Professor Ngozi, Omori. A gentle and humble man who manages two portfolios without stint. Professor Joel Abolata, my DVC Ekama, whose love and support for music has been very crucial to the Imagine Music Program. I recognize the register, Mr. Sotasewell, for keeping the record. The librarian, Dr. Duke Abati, I thank you for your support in the purchase of rare music books. And I took him a list. They are not available, but we found them in Ghana. Important. I appreciate the brother, Dr. Victor Imabe, for the difficult task of managing the time. You know that I have. And we can't blame you. My respect to my dean, Professor Eddie Erabi, the commentator of all time. I appreciate His Royal Majesty, Abogini Obi Nduka, the Obi of Iselu, and the good people of Iselu, I acknowledge my lecturers who taught and supervised my first, second, and third degree. I acknowledge my Archbishop Augustine Akubeze of Benin Archdiocese, who is here well represented. I acknowledge Father Obinyan of St. Albans Catholic Church, Father Matthew Adejo, and my parish priest. My parish priest. Father Adejo, your first mother is here. You can see her. the Baba of theatre now, in the absence of Awudi and the rest. Professor Chris Ugolo.
Mokwunyei, and her husband, Dr. Prof, Mr. Akin, and his
know. Critical research presented is traveling the disciplines of music and theatre, but have also had initial discoveries become essential, not only as contributor to knowledge, but also as motivation for much needed collaboration in current practices of music and theatre. Whereas the playwright's primary means of expression is speech, which leaves the dramatist entirely dependent on dialogue and stage rehearsal to convey his concept, other means of communication and expression with a total theatre effect of related cultural factors, such as singing, drumming, and dancing, become evident, useful, and expected as other means of communication in Nigerian culture. And that was what he was giving to the public. Recommendations. I recommend that contemporary theatre art practitioners should resort to African traditions and culture for traditional idioms and practices that portray our identity as African. That music should be integrated as a means of communication in any drama that seeks to identify with the roots of the Nigerian audience. I thank Almighty God for her big honor and fulfillment of my inaugural lecture today. I thank you all for your kind attention. Praise the Lord!
distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, but for the very nice and beautiful music, I was going to go to Carpenter because we had a seated debate into what we are. But anyway, thank you for the music, the beautiful music. I also, the head of the department, I thought I was the number one woman here. Why did you get all that applause that I didn't get?
Thank you.
COB, please join in the process. Thank you.